I'm going to tell you how to start a relationship with God. I've said this 1,000 times and I will continue to say this because it's so important. A relationship, any relationship is built off of 3 things. Communication, spending time with the person, and getting to know the person. And that is the exact same thing with God. Communicate with him, pray to him, just talk to him. Sometimes we overcomplicate prayer when it's just talking to God. It's talking to him about your day. It's talking to him about what you're going through, your struggles, and repenting of your sins that you have done. Asking for forgiveness. Just talking to God. Next is getting to know God. How do you start a relationship, or how do you even trust someone that you don't know? So open the Bible. 2 Timothy 3:16 talks about how that's God's breathed out word. You want to know who God is? Look in the Bible, because that's where he's revealed his character in. And spend time with him. It is so important to have a daily routine so you have motivation to do this. Some days I wake up and I don't want to read my Bible. I'm lacking motivation. But the routine and spending time with God is what motivates me. So I hope this helped.
The Science Behind Why People Gossip and When It Can Be a Good Thing by Sunland Apple, IPTV Entertainment. Gossip. All humans partake in some form, despite the age-old adage, if you have nothing nice to say, don't say anything at all. Whether it's workplace chatter, the sharing of family news, or group texts between friends, it's inevitable that everyone who talks well, talks about other people. In fact, a 1993 observational study found that male participants spent 55% of conversation time and female participants spent 67% conversation time on the discussion of socially relevant topics. People tend to think of gossip as synonymous with malicious rumors, put-downs, or the breathless propagation of a tabloid scoop. But researchers often define it more broadly, as talking about people who aren't present, says Megan Robbins, an assistant professor of psychology at the University of California, Riverside. It's something that comes very naturally to us, an integral part of conversation, information sharing, and even community building.
Here's the other thing you need to understand about gossiping. If they're doing it with you, they'll do it about you when you're not there. People gossip as a way to bond with other people. It's called triangulation. Narcissists do this in particular. By talking about other people in a derogatory way, the people that are gossiping are trying to build a bond with you. That means the second you're not there, they will trash you in order to build a bond with other people. And when you really get that as a truth, because it is a truth, that people who gossip with you gossip about you, that will change how you look at all your relationships. And when you become the kind of person that makes it a rule to not gossip about people, you will surround yourself with other people who don't gossip about you. And that is a powerful change in your life.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment. Perfected Faces, done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work, and he will surely see it through to the end. He says he makes all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it is explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if he finds you, he is big enough, strong enough and able enough to secure you and to keep you. Got to believe that. In the book of Matthew, Matthew chapter 6 verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to him, you will not be able to know him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if he found you and he's brought you this far, then he's faithful enough, he's able enough, and he's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because he does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No. The Lord finishes his work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, he gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me," and what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, he says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, he will reveal himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to him, when you pursue him, when you crave him, when you hunger for him, God loves to be pursued, and he loves to reveal himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it will be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts a zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impahla zonzakalayo zizohola. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sister Lerato. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold you back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this the same thing that God says, come as you are? It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that, I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sister Lerato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sister Lerato. It says, first meaning is from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like, dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Sister Lerato. My friends, when I shut my
wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things are to focus you, but when you're in the room, they notice you. Tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control.